Goedemorgen.
Goedemorgen.
Gefeliciteerd.
Dankjewel.
Gisteren.
Ja.
Geweldig.
Ja.
Ik had hem zomaar kunnen winnen. Vanuit het dode spoor.
Ik denk er even een tel op. Maar,
ja.
Ja, ja.
Net niet, maar
nee,
toch
nee.
Briljant. Ja, super toch. Robin, gefeliciteerd.
Ja. Net niet, hè?
Ja, je had hem zomaar kunnen winnen, maar... Godverdikkie, na zo'n koers.
Dat
had
het wel verdiend.
Oh, wauw. Geweldig.
Ja. Lenger ut på banan har vi du och ni och Mermaid och CT och Miss Penis. Vi har ekipagen vid upploppet börjar invändigt 60 Levarkäll. 60 Levarkäll utmändigt har vi 7 Aida Boko. Sida vid sida är de, de Levarkäll. 7 Aida Boko, 8 Kavaka B, 5 bit ut. De Levarkäll är Aida Boko, de Levarkäll.
Ik heb de koers helaas niet kunnen zien, want ik zat in het vliegtuig. En ik heb hem voorlopig nog nergens teruggevonden, maar ging niet makkelijk.
Ja, het was een mooie koers. Ik was tweede aankomende. De winnaar ging eruit.
Oké, op die manier.
Hendrik.
Ja.
Het liep heel goed. Ik was zeer tevreden.
Ja, ja. En terecht de winnaar. Hinderen mag niet, dus ben je altijd terecht winnaar.
Ja, het is
toch
mooier om zelf te winnen, maar...
Tuurlijk.
Ja.
Het siertje bescheidenheid weer dat je er zelf over begint, want ik wist het niet eens. Bedankt Rick.
Graag gedaan.
This is Mariska. She's the groom for Groningen. This is Delphine Flevo. She was a winner yesterday. Keeping the spirit of the Dutchies high. Delphine Flevo. And this is Aida Boko. She was second yesterday, super strong yesterday. She was in the death seat, first over in the big race for the mares, the elite race. Aida was second, fantastic. Two great Dutch girls, three great Dutch girls. Corky. He's running tonight and he will be good. This is Uncle Peter. We don't want to take him out because he has to stay calm and relaxed for today. So we leave him alone. This is him, Uncle Peter. Go, go. He's beautiful. Who is this?
Dave's Castillo.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Yes, it's the best. The whole thing, the whole thing, the whole thing, the whole thing.
Sanity, I guess.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah.
It's just a wild guess for all the girls with the 70 shirts.
They weren't really invited to anything or asked anything, so we're going home.
And we move over to the right. There's Maven. We're all on the same bus. Caroline and Maven. There she is.
Because I know in America she leaves the gate pretty fast. How do you think, how do you estimate that here in Sweden? Because the gate leaves in a different way.
Yeah, so I mean, we kind of already been practiced a little on that too. Since, okay. I mean, in the States, they kind of timed the gate a little bit more. But in qualifiers in the race out in Ohio, we were on the gate early.
Okay.
Just to kind of have her, try to have her used to that too, that it's, that you have to be on the gate. So, I mean, we've been.
So you think she's up to it to leave fast over here as well?
I think she can. So that's to get very fast horses on the inside. So, and I don't know what Yannick is going to do. Because Yannick don't tell me how to train and I don't tell him how to ride. So
exactly.
That's kind of our, that's our deal we have. I mean, that's.
And a couple of pretty fast leafers on their inside. So
yeah.
I think when he really hits the gas, he has a problem.
I
recall Andy Miller racing him with Lucky Jim 2 or 3 years ago. And he was parked in the third trail of the first kilometer. So, but I guess she can race in any way. She coming can, from cover.
Yeah, she's done it from everywhere. Can, so I mean that's what kind of makes me not really worried where we get away, because she can race from behind. She can race in the lead. I mean, it's, I'm just hoping we don't get locked in. That's
exactly. Yeah. I can imagine that you don't consider winning the elimination has no priority.
No.
It's basically getting to the final.
Making it to the final, that's kind of where we're at. And then
so maybe, obviously it's up to Yannick, but maybe a little bit more conservative trip.
Definitely gonna try, because like he said too, we didn't come here to finish second. We didn't,
and when you would win, you would get a better gate.
Yeah, you get a better post too. Yeah, so that's, I mean, it's all.
Well, anyway, one really big Dutch fan. At least one cheering.
Yep.
And everybody in America, I saw that on Facebook and Twitter.
Yeah.
USA and Canada are backing up too. Yeah.
Before you start working with Per, were you already involved with horses back in Sweden?
Yeah, we had ponies when I was a kid. So I was racing ponies here, and grew up with horses. I mean, I've been competing and jumping and dressage and that stuff
so
when I was
all
a kid.
Horse,
so, yeah, and then when I was 18.
Can you come out?
Huh?
I need you to come out.
Okay.
No problem. See,
thank you, man. Beautiful.
Yeah,
Yannick,
I'm sorry, maybe, do you have 5 minutes time for a Dutch interview?
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool, man.
Okay, how do you enjoy your stay in Sweden until now?
It's
I have to congratulate you with your victory.
Yeah, it was good. It was good to get a little confidence going into today, you know, like the first couple of days. No, I had decent horses actually, but the trip didn't work out, and I had bad post. And I had a bad post in this race as well, but the trip kind of worked out this time. And I got to the winner's circle, definitely feels good.
What do you think about the tactics in the races over here compared to America? Do you think of it as a big difference? And did you already get used to that, you think?
It's definitely a difference. No, I mean, I don't know if it's a big difference. It's definitely more tactical and less speed, maybe. But I believe the elite lap, the race itself, would be it's going to be American type of racing. I mean, there's no trailers. You know, that makes a difference. You know, I mean, you know, when you leave the gate and there's 12 horses in the race, you know, positioning is even more important. Now we're going to go back to the 8 horses, everybody falls on the gate, and I think there'll be a lot of speed, so I think it fits my style even better.
Okay. How do you estimate the difference of the gate speed over here compared back to America, and how do you think that translates to Maven? Do you think she has the same kind of gate speed over here as she did back home?
Probably, yeah, because she's really handy, but it is a big difference. No, that's probably the biggest difference, even more so than racing style, is how slow the starting gate goes. Yeah. You really, really going slow, and then it takes off. You know, so but I'm glad I got to race in all five horses so far. I have one more, so you know, get used to the gate. I'm glad that my first drive wasn't Maven, because I don't think I would have been ready. You know, and I wish I had 10 more drives, but it is what it is. You know, so you play the cards you're dealt, and I think I'm ready.
I can recall Andy Miller driving Lucky Jim 3 or 4 years ago, and I don't think he did any races prior to the other one. And he left the gate, and he was parked in the third trail for the first kilometer. Are you willing to take a risk to leave, or are you kind of a bit more conservative in the eliminations with the priority of getting to the final?
I don't know. You know, I mean, we'll decide that when the gate opens. It doesn't only depend on me. You know, it depends a lot on the other horses as well. You know, so you gotta adjust. Once the gate opens, we'll see what happens. You know, my horse, she can do anything. You know, I can sit on the outside the whole race, and I think she can do really good. You know, she can sit behind cover and do really well, and when she makes her front, she'd be really good there too. You know, so try to get the smoothest trip as possible, but she's ready.
Okay. How well do you know your opponents in the eliminations? Because I guess you're aware there are a couple of pretty fast levers on your inside.
Yeah, there's a lot of levers in there. I've watched replay on all of them. I know the competition a little bit. You know what I mean? Like, I wish I knew them better. But you know, that's kind of my strength a little bit in the United States. You know, I know every horse in every race. I got a great memory, and you know, I come here at a little bit of a disadvantage for me, because you know, you can watch videos all you want, it's not the same.
Yeah.
You know? So I think hopefully, and I think we will make the second heat, and then if we do make the second heat, I'll be even more ready, because then okay. I get to watch them race live one time. And so the first trip, you know, you want to win the race, there's no doubt about it. You know, you want to, you know, get a good position for the final. But I think you know, if we do well in the first heat, we'll do better in the second one.
Okay. Well, I would like to thank you a lot for your time. And just be sure we'll be rooting for you, because we really like Maven.
Oh yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Het is zondagochtend op een warm en zonnig stalterrein van Zovalla. Henk Grift is een van de Nederlandse kanshebbers van vandaag. Hij heeft het niet getroffen met zijn startnummer, nummer 8, nu. Maar Henk denkt dat hij toch niet helemaal kansloos is. Of zeg ik dat verkeerd, Henk?
Nee, kijk, 8 is niet een voordeel. Maar voor hem ook niet helemaal een nadeel, omdat hij een beetje bangerig is. Dus ik heb hem liever een beetje uit de paard ertussen. En als hij een beetje positie krijgt, dan zie ik hem ver komen. Het is een klassepaard, heeft hij Belangenweg al bewezen. Dit jaar 2 keer gewonnen tegen oude paarden in Duitsland. Op een goede manier. En ik acht hem zeker niet kansloos vandaag.
Stel nou wat je dit weekend Arend nog niet zo heel vaak hebt gezien, maar wat in Zweden eigenlijk best wel veel gebeurt. Er neemt eentje de kop en die gaat 18 rijden onderweg. Wat zal dan de tactiek van Jesse zijn?
Dan rijden we waarschijnlijk op. Dan doen we het net zoals Kielström. Dan gaan we ernaast rijden.
En dat maakt niet uit, blijf je dan in hetzelfde tempo als je 18 rijden, of ga je dan wel de druk opvoeren?
Nou, voeren wel de druk op natuurlijk. Ik bedoel, ik heb zelf ook veel speed, maar het probleem is als het 18 gaat en je ligt natuurlijk 50 paard buitenkant, dus de laatste 800 meter in 10. En dan moet je het goed maken, moet je in 5, dat heeft geen zin.
Nee, precies.
Dus we proberen dan zelf wel de koers te maken buitenom, maar ik kan me haast niet voorstellen op zo'n dag met dit weer vandaag. En we hebben Colgini in de koers en die houdt niet van traag rijden. Dus ik denk dat er wel tempo in de koers komt.
Dus het komt er eigenlijk een beetje op neer. Ideaal scenario is van huis uit mooie positie vinden. Derde, vierde paard in tweede spoor. Mooi hoog tempo. En dan de laatste 800 meter zelf de aanval zoeken.
Ja, dat is wel de bedoeling.
En nou ja, dan gaan we er maar vanuit dat we grote kans hebben om een nieuwe oranje overwinning, of niet?
Ik hoop het wel. Ik heb een goed gevoel in ieder geval bij de paard. Dus, ik hoop het.
In ieder geval bedankt voor je tijd en we nemen er straks misschien nog eventjes een biertje op.
Ik hoop het. Dankjewel.